From the crypt here, about to record my fourth loss in a row. Because I can't seem to record a win. Oh my goodness, Shuffler, what are you doing? Every time. I'm so annoyed with this nonsense at this point. Hopefully this isn't some amulet deck. It's that blue-green control. Can we ever get anything other than what we don't need? Okay, that's not too bad. So we probably want to go for Blast Zone, it seems. Plenty of mana. Worm Coil's good. It's most likely going to get countered. Here comes the counter. Do, 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 do. See if we can get past the mana leak. I'm sure they have another way of countering it. At this point, we can't not try to go around it. I'm sure they have a cryptic command to bounce it back to my hand. And a turn. Quaddle. Kind of Uro deck. Yeah, I've seen this before, so not attacking with the Goyf is interesting. Ooh. So I think we want to try to put this down. He's got the mana leak. I think he would have used on the other coil. Could be a stubborn denial, which would be awful. Force negation. Mana leak, of course. I guess I should have attacked there to get myself some life, but it's okay. Okay, I'm pretty sure I should have attacked there. I blocked with this 1/1. Interesting. So for a creature, it could have a counter. So think ultimately we want to try to play out the Once Upon a Time. Try to get the big whiffs. Yeah, that's fine. They probably have another one, but at this point, we want the life. We have the death touch blocker. They said they've had enough. Well, it feels good to have a win. So I'm not sure what's the greatest here. We definitely want relics. Players can't cast spells from graveyards or library. Can't enter the battlefield. So I think we want to put cages in. So what? We want claims, hoping that they'll probably play a dampening sphere. First and foremost, you probably want the Thrag Tusk. It doesn't seem that Ballista is the best here. It's good, but not really. We can cut maybe two Once Upon a Times. Do something like that. I'm also going to want the cages. Let's see, a cage and a relic. Get rid of. Seems like it might be too slow. And one of these. Try something like this. We can start off with a Stirrings. This is probably a questionable keep, but if we can Stirrings into anything relevant or useful, particularly we want the Tron land here. They are just going off here. Yeah, I think this is the best plan of action. Ooh, I can get him on the relic. How useful is relic right now? Because they drop a Tarmogoyf, we're not going to be in the greatest position. Yeah, I don't need map, so we'll grab relic. They're gonna keep the Monolique. No, they say running six all the way. We're gonna keep getting land. Which is fine. So I can pop the graveyard if need be. So let's look for the power plant. Of course, we don't get it. Play Karn in the order, play the mine, play the relic. Yep. Uro. Snappy. Visions. Opponent's looking real good right now. Could have been useful if we got the other land. So I think we got to go scrying, get our power plant. Oh. Yeah, we showed them the tower. That was wrong. Should have played the power plant. But it's okay. Hope they tap out here for something. Uro, do something, please. They should have done running six there. Lost priority on that. Uro. Astrolabe Madness. So they're going the mana leak route. Which is totally fine. Well, it's not totally fine, but I could play Karn here, get that leaked, or play this and play another one. Seems like a good... Interessante. So, that is... So, I think I'm going to do this on the draw. So, go to their turn. Do this with that on the stack. We go this. Give him no chance to play run in six. JC. JC boy. So they probably have a pact. See right here. We can lead out with another one of these. Give them one more turn to do something. Is digging hardcore. Okay. I feel like I'm gonna see counters for the rest of the game here. If we can keep top decking live, we'll be looking good. We can also get a blast zone for two and get that off the board. Ugin would be wonderful here. Thank you. Well, we will just keep drawing land. It's the name of the game. Get a forest, and then we'll play this. We'll let them try to target it if they so choose. We do have Nature's Claims in the deck, so not totally out of it. It's just, it's going to be really hard with this Jace filtering 3 cards. 30 cards left. He's essentially looking through a good majority of his deck. This point, keep cycling. That's a nice little wombo combo. Just pop this. We'll just go for a mine just in case. Sure, I'll be countered. That is nice. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 2, 4, 7. Can't play it this turn. Guaranteed it gets countered next turn. So really need threat. Yep, we can keep cycling land. Drago, typical nonsense. So play this, play that out. What we draw, and then we're just gonna go for it because it's gonna get countered anyway, so whatever. Opponent has this busted up, they're drawing a million cards, filtering their land. So however many counters they have left in their deck, I'm pretty sure they have them all in hand at this point. Once Renin 6 goes online, what is that? You get the instant sorcery cards of retrace. Okay. So, as fun as the first game was, here we are again, looking not so good. Yep. There's about a 99.9999999 repeating chance we're gonna see a counter. And I'm pretty sure we'll probably see our third forest for the draw step here. back to the drawing board. So the claims are useful. Yeah, we'll just run it back. Use a life, play that into the well, mulligan, we want Tron lands. This is better, we can pitch the Thrag Tusk and in the hopes and dreams plan. Play this into map. She probably isn't correct. Maybe she should have done sphere there, but I just want to play this, and then we can draw two and do expedition map next turn. Give us a Tron land. Do this, we'll draw another one. Just in case we get it. Probably get a big whiff here. So get the power plant. Put them back in any order. Play this. And we'll pop this for the tower. Not quite sure what that's gonna do exactly for us, being that we can't do anything, but we could get lucky. Nice. Run this out. Monolink. Oh, well. That is interesting. So you might have Ancient Grudge. So it's looking better now that we got that worm coil down. See what the opponent has. If they take out the worm coil with Ancient Grudge, they don't. I guess they can flash it back. That'd still be 3 damage at Ren. I play a Blue Moon or Blood Moon, I can go get green and get off that back onto Tron. place bouncing the worm coil? That's interesting. So they're probably packed up. Now play the worm coil. Since I already have this up, I'll just Sylvan Scrying mana efficiency to get the tower. Hopefully get a good draw here. He's drawing with Jace, which is interesting. Probably might have a cryptic command. To Ren. Definitely gonna swing the coil at Ren. See what he does. Hopefully we draw something good. Go to the run at 6. Yep. I figure that's what they had. So we will draw here. Seven, eight, nine. We are one short. A day late and a dollar short. So they're trying to run shenanigans again. See you, Mama. So, exile, exile. Take up that Ren. Sure. Oh wow. What is going on, Ro? Okay. So exile, exile. What's okay, so I want to go boop, 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 boop. Do this. Somehow makes it out alive, so you're gonna go at Jace, and you're gonna go at... Nope. That was a good start there. If I can get this Ulamog attacking, it's not gonna look good for them. Kind of fully expecting a cryptic command here. Running six, what do you know? Interesting. So Ulamog's gonna attack him, and both Worms are going to go after Ren. Ooh, nice, nice, nice. So... Opponent probably has cryptic commands for days. So what is? I'll be down when I'm done, babe. Okay. So I really need relic. So put this at 2 and pop it next turn. don't think you're expecting that, OP. But whoa, whoa. Hold up. 1, 2, 3. Six, seven. Sure, but if I draw another land, opponent is not going to be looking very good. Sure. One land to rule them all. Euro. Of course, of course. Just send the lifelinker. He's gonna have Burrow. He is going to counter anything I do. Yeah, send the lifelinker. Play Ugin. Cryptic command. It's gonna come down to the wire here. Yep. So So they could Uro and keep up Cryptic, which is completely fine. We'll still block the Tarmogoyf. Then if we have one more mana, we have Ulamog into Exile, or Exile both their creatures. It'd be interesting to see. I'd imagine this is going to be an Uro here. I could go Exile, Exile. Okay, then take the land from their hand and put it up there. So, if we could draw land here, I think we're going to do Goyf Uro. He'll have, is it permanent? Yeah, he'll be able to take a permanent back to his hand. Yep. Might have shot himself in the foot here. Be a land one time. Ooh. Do both these creatures. No color to the spell counter. It's fine. Those two are gone. Gives me time to gain some life. I can kill my artifact. Counter, lose land, go ahead, don't care. I'm on 11 turn clock. Significantly reduces said clock. So I'm dead. This is gonna cryptic anything. I really need to draw an Ulamog off the top to stay alive. Man, this game sometimes, I swear. Hashtag never lucky. Man, that sucks. Oh, recorded another loss. What do you know? Four in a row.